So we're continuing with the pastime of Lord Varaha Avatar. You remember Lord Varaha is the boar.
我们记得主 Varaha 是一只猪的形体。
He performed two activities. He picked up the earth from the bottom of the ocean.
他进行了两项活动，一个是呢，把这个地球从这个宇宙的底层把它抬起来。
The earth had fallen into the bottom of the universe.
这个地球呢，沉落到这个宇宙的底层。
And then the other activity was that he killed the demon Hiranyaksha.
另外一个活动就是他杀了恶魔Hiranyaksha.
Hiranyaksha was terrorizing the whole universe.
Hiranyaksha 就说他这个把整个宇宙都惊吓了，震恐的。Lord Varaha
fought with him and killed him.
那主 Varaha 就跟他打斗，然后把他杀了。
So we also spoke about the relationship between Lord Brahma and his different sons.
我们也提到了 Brahma 还有他的不同的儿子。
There was an example of the four Kumaras who did not accept the instruction of their father, Lord Brahma.
那有一个例子来说到呢，就是说四个Kumara他们不接受父亲呢 Brahma 的训令。
But they're not considered fallen because they rejected the order of their father in the interest of their spiritual advancement.
虽然是拒绝这个父亲 Brahma 的训示，可是呢，并不是堕落的原因，而是他们有更高层的灵性的原因。The
four Kumaras told their father they were going to remain young children, and they wanted to pursue the path of self-realization.
四个 Kumara 就告诉父亲说，他们要保持年轻的这个身体。
And the other example was Manu. Manu, on the other hand, he was given the order by his father, Brahma, and he immediately accepted it.
另外一个例子就是说，这个 Manu 呢，他接受父亲 Brahma 的训示，做这个创造者。
So when we're following the principles of organized society, then son should be obedient to the father.
如果我们遵循呢这个社会的规范的话呢，这就像是他遵守着父亲 Brahma 的这个训示。
And unless one is very elevated, very high purpose in mind, they should remain obedient.
除非呢，一个人是已经是很 高的层次，自我觉悟的层次很高，否则还是要遵守，就是这样的服从。There
was also the example of the demonic qualities shown by this demon Hiranyaksha, who was ultimately killed by Lord
Varaha。还有另外一个例子，就是说这个一个恶魔品质的这个人呢，Hiranyaksha，然后他后来被主来杀掉。
So in the Bhagavad Gita chapter 16, Lord Krishna is describing the divine and then he also describes the demoniac
qualities.
So the demoniac quality is we think that there is no God, that the world is just there for sense gratification.
那么，恶魔性质，这个品质是什么呢？就是说，他们认为没有神，然后生物就是只要进行感官享乐这些事。And
whoever is our enemies, we can kill them.
而且认为，只要是我们的敌人，都可以去把他们杀掉。
And in this way, we will think we can enjoy the world forever.
然后用这样认为呢，我们就可以在这个世界上任意的享受。
So this brought on the death of Hiranyaksha.
所以这个就引致的 Hiranyaksha 的死亡。
And we also spoke about how there's a relationship between the disturbances which take place on the planet and how they relate to an increase of demonic population.
然后我们有说到呢，这个大这个地球啊，星球上的各种困扰灾难呢，是由于这个恶魔性质的人口在增加。
When there's some very bad storm and the trees are all uprooted or there's tremors and the sun and the moon may be covered, there may be eclipses and so on. So these kind of disturbances indicate that some demons are taking over.
如果大自然非常强烈的暴动啦，风暴啦，或者狂风暴雨把树根都拔起来，或者说太阳啊、月亮都被遮蔽了，那表示说有这个恶魔性质很强烈的生物出生。
So chapter 14 begins with Vidura talking to Maitreya. He wanted to know what was the reason for the fight between the demon king and Lord Boar, Lord Varaha.
然后这个第四章又开始再继续说了。这个 Vidura 就问着这个 Maitreya， 这个为什么呢？这个主哈、啊，这个豪猪的形象跟这个恶魔国王在这边打斗。
And Maitreya is replying to Vidura by explaining about how Diti became pregnant at an inauspicious time。
那 Maitreya 就解释了，就是说这个Diti 他。他的受孕的时候呢，是在不吉祥的时候进行的。
Maitreya was describing how Diti had approached her husband, who was a great sage called Kashyapa, and she requested him to give her a child.
那 Maitreya 就说明叙述了，就是说这个 Diti 当时在祈求她的丈夫 Kashyapa 是一个很伟大的圣人。然后请求她的丈夫让她怀个孩子，这样子。
So Kashyapa told Diti that you have to wait because this is not the auspicious time. This is the evening time. It's not appropriate at this time.
那 Kashyapa 就跟这个老婆 Diti 说，你要稍微等一等，这个时候就是日夜交接黄昏那个时段是不吉祥的时候，要再等一下。
Here you can see Kashyapa with his good wife Diti.
图片上就是这个圣人 Kashyapa 跟他的这么好的老婆 Diti 在那儿。
Kashyapa actually has many wives. He had accepted, I think it, there was 13 wives. They were all sisters.
Kashyapa 他有很多个老婆，大概三个，而且这些老婆们都是姐妹。
They were all daughters of Daksha.
这是三个女子都是 Daksha 的女儿。
And they had inquired, you know, that the father, it's the duty of the father to make arrangements for the marriage of his daughter.
所以这是一个父亲的职责，要安排这个女儿们的这个结婚。
So Daksha, the daughters, they didn't tell their father who they wanted to marry, but they told their grandmother.
那这些女孩嘛，没有跟父亲说她们想要去嫁给谁，可是她们跟她们的奶奶来说。
And the grandmother told the father that.These girls, they all want to marry this one man, Kashyapa.
所以他们这个奶奶呢，就是这个姥姥呢，就告诉的这个开始盘说，他们这些就跟那个国王说呢，他们的女儿都想嫁给这个圣人。
So Kashyapa was a great sage. He somehow he was able to accept so many wives.
那么Kashyapa 他是一个很伟大的圣人，而他有足够的能力来照顾这样十三个老婆。
We know in the past, that kind of thing was popular. People great. There's usually more ladies on the planet than there are men. So it requires men to accept some often more wives, more than one wife. But they have to be qualified.
在地球上呢，女子胜人数胜过于男子，所以就必须要有相当的人来照顾他们。但是一个人要娶比较多的老婆，这样子的人也必须要是有资格才可以。
And the Kali, in this age, people are not qualified. That's the problem.
在卡利年代，人们没有资格，这是一个问题。
We can see just to maintain one wife, people can.
我们可以看到现代人们要维持一个老婆这样的家庭都还觉得很困难。
So Kashyapa was approached by his wife, Diti. She was requesting him that, please, I want to have a child.
那 Kashyapa 就必须安抚他的老婆，因为他老婆说想要有孩子。
And she was it was not unnatural for her to be in that situation because all of the other wives, all of the other co-wives, they all had children. She was the only wife who didn't have a child.
那对她来讲，这是比较不一样，跟其他的所谓姐妹，就是这个圣人的老婆不一样，就是说其他的这些圣人的老婆都已经有孩子，可是她还没有孩子。
They were all her sisters. They were her co-wives, and they all had children. She was the only one who didn't have a child.
那这个圣人的老婆，其他老婆都是这个老婆的姐妹，她们都已经有孩子，可是只有她还没有孩子。
So she was not really wrong in approaching her husband.
所以她去要求她丈夫让她可以怀上孩子也没有错。
The only problem was that it was an inauspicious time.
唯一的问题就是说，那个时候是一个不吉祥的时候。
So Kashyapa pacifies his wife by glorifying her. And not only does he glorify her, but he glorifies the position of a wife in general, how they perform very valuable service.
这个开始吧呢，就先安抚他的老婆，以这个来所谓赞扬他的老婆哈，就是说一个老婆一个妻子，就是说是一般是怎么样的进行他们的一些各种重要的服务。
Wife is considered the better half of the husband because she's expected to help the husband perform half of the service.
一个妻子被认为是丈夫的另外的好的一半，因为她在协助丈夫其他的这个事务。
The wife has the duty to look after the husband, to keep the home neat and clean, and to prepare meals for the husband.
老婆呢就必须留在家里照顾丈夫家务的需要啊，把家里打扫干净整洁啦，准备丈夫回来有饭吃啊，这些事。
And the wife helps the husband also in controlling his senses and mind.
然后这个老婆也帮助丈夫来约制这个心意跟感官。
So Kashyapa is encouraging his wife and praising her, oh, you're such a, you know, your service is so important to me.
所以开始吧，就在鼓励他的老婆，就说哦，你做这一些家务，这个是非常重要的。
But then Kashyapa warned his wife that don't underestimate the importance of Lord Shiva.
而同时呢。Kashyapa 又跟老婆说呢，就是警告她不要低估了 Shiva 的重要性。
Now Lord Shiva, he comes around in the evening, just at dusk, just as the day is changing into night, and he comes around with all of his ghosts and other associates.
这个 Shiva 呢，他出现的时候就是 白天跟黑夜交接那个时段哈，就是那个黄昏日落交际的时候，那时候西巴会跟他那一些鬼魂罗罗一起出来。
So in this way, Kashyapa was warning his wife that this is not the auspicious time.
所以 Kashyapa 就警告他的老婆说，啊，这个时候是不吉祥的时候。
You have to wait.
就是说你必须要等一等。
Because if you don't wait, you're going to commit an offense against Lord Shiva.
因为如果你不等的话呢，你就会冒犯了 Shiva。
However, Diti was, as described here, she was overwhelmed by her desire for union with her husband, and she caught hold of the sage just like a shameless prostitute.
这个 Diti 呢，她受到这个感官的侵蚀，强烈的侵蚀，所以她就没办法控制的抓着这个丈夫的衣服，这样子。
So although they were married, because they were not acting according to religious principles, so their activity was irreligious.
虽然他们就是说他们是结婚的人，但是没有根据宗教原则的行为，这样呢就不是在规范里面的。
So even though, So Kashyapa was obligated, he had no choice, he had to engage in union, satisfy his wife with sex, although it was a very inauspicious time.
那么Kashyapa 他是一个身为一个丈夫就有这个义务来满足妻子的要求，即便说那个时候是不吉祥的时刻。
So Kashyapa had warned his wife that this will be an offense against Lord Shiva.So his wife, Diti, begged her husband, please help me in pacifying Lord Shiva.
这个开始话也知道这个时刻是很不吉祥的，但是 Diti 又忍耐不住，所以呢 Diti 又要求他这个婆罗门丈夫来帮他去跟Shiva 安抚 Shiva。
Lord Shiva is related to Kashyapa like a brother, because Lord Shiva's wife is also one of the daughters, is it the sister of his own wife?
Shiva 跟 Kashyapa, Shiva 把 Kashyapa 当作是自己兄弟一样，因为 Shiva 的老婆也是这个 Diti 的姐妹之一。
We said the daughter of Daksha, right? Daksha had many daughters.
So,这个都是这个 Daksha 这个国王的女儿哈。
So 13 daughters they chose Kashyapa for their husband.
然后在这个国王Daksha 的十三个这么多女儿，十三个女儿选择这个 Kashyapa 这个圣人成为丈夫。
But Uma is it?
Uma,
the wife of Lord Shiva.
Sati.
Sati, yes, Sati better, right? Sati.She had chosen, she told, she wanted to marry Lord Shiva.
那其中一个女儿 Sati, 她的愿望是要嫁给 Shiva.
So Sati, so look, you can see Lord Shiva and Kashyapa, they're related to each other.
所以由于这个老婆之间的姐妹关系，所以 Shiva 跟 Kashyapa,他们也变成在这个所谓亲戚关系的连接。
Brothers in law。
就是这个叫做。
So,
这个妹夫姐夫这一类的这样子。
So Diti was thinking that by that relationship, her husband, being a little older, being senior to Lord Shiva, he would be able to pacify Lord Shiva.
那 Diti 呢？她认为她的丈夫。是吧稍微年长一点，所以呢他的丈夫 Kashyapa 应该可以来安抚这个是吧。
However, Kashyapa told his wife that everything was inauspicious.
那不论怎么样呢，凯什法还是跟他老婆在说，这个时间是不吉祥的。
And the result of their union would be that she would give birth, but the children she would give birth to would be demons.
而且，他们这样的结果肯定会有孩子生出来，而且生出两个儿子，这两个儿子却又是恶魔性格的。
She would have two sons. You think, oh, very good, two sons, so very nice.
跟他说
But if they're demons,
就说哎呀，一次可以生两个儿子太好了。可是要是这个儿子是恶魔的话，你就等着瞧吧。
You have sons who are going to kill poor, faultless living entities and torture women.
那这样的儿子会去残杀无辜啊，甚至而且去侵犯虐待女子这样的情形。
So you can understand Kashyapa was really a very powerful sage, a very great husband. He could understand the outcome, he could understand what kind of children his wife's going to have.
所以可以知道呢， Kashyapa 确实是一个非常强而有力的一个圣人，他可以知道将会发生出生的儿子，而且是什么样的儿子。
And he could predict the future.How the Lord would come and he would kill both these two sons.
而且他也能够预言，就是说主会出怎么样的出现，而且会怎么样把这两个孩子杀掉。
So one was killed by Lord Varaha and the other was killed by Lord Narsimha.
所以这两个儿子，一个被这个主 Varaha 这个三猪形体这个来杀掉，另外一个是被
So in some ways it's a comfort to Diti, the mother. She's going to give birth to two children who are going to be demons, but they're going to be killed by the Lord himself. So that's a blessing.
所以这个对 Diti 就是身为一个母亲来讲，她也有一些可以安慰的地方，就是虽然会生了两个恶魔的孩子。但是呢，又会被主所杀害而得到解救。
So Kashyapa continued to explain to his wife that because of her lamentation and because of her lamentation, her penitence, and her unflinching faith in the Lord.And because of her adoration for Lord Shiva and her husband, one of the sons of her son, she would give birth to two sons. So one of her, she would have a grandson who would be Prahlad, and he will be a great devotee of the Lord.
那么开始
啊，
就继续对他的这个妻子来说明。就是因为他的妻子听到这样在感伤难过，然后也有一些苦情这种苦楚，但是同时他的妻子又对主有着很坚定的信心，而且非常的仰慕的主虚瓦还有对他的丈夫他也非常仰慕，那他的丈夫也是然后他因为他自己会生出两个儿子，一个会被这个三族的瓦拉杀掉，那另外一个儿子后来会再生出一个儿子叫 Prahlad 那就是Prahlad 会变成一个族的一个伟大的贡献者。
So the good qualities of Diti are mentioned here.
所以 Diti 的他的良好的品质在这里有提到的。
Diti has there's one sister of Diti called Aditi.And she's like the mother of the demigods.
Diti 还有一个姐妹叫做 Aditi， 也是所有半神人们的母亲。
So these ladies are also just as their husband is not ordinary. These ladies are also not ordinary. They're very special people.
所以像 Diti、Aditi 他们这一些女子们都不是一般女人，而就像他们丈夫是非常。 杰出的人物，他们也是非常特别的人物。
So after Diti had forced her husband into the irreligious activity, then she had come to her senses and she felt guilty about it.
那 Diti 呢，在跟丈夫圆房之后，她后来好像清醒了，脑筋清醒了，突然觉得很罪恶，自己进行了这种非宗教行为的事。
So she lamented that she'd done the activity.
所以她就在那边难过着，说她做了这样的事。
The penitent, the mood of penitence that she wants to do something to make up for her wrong.
所以呢，她除了难过感伤之外，她就想要来补偿她犯的错误，而去做一些苦行。
And she has great, very strong faith in the Supreme Lord.
而且她对至尊主有强大的信心。
And she's also full of adoration for Lord Shiva.
而同时她对这个 Shiva 是充满了仰慕。
Lord Shiva is the husband of one of her sisters, but she understands Lord Shiva also to be a very great personality.
Shiva 是她其中一个姐妹的丈夫，但她也了解这个 Shiva 是一个非常伟大的人物。
And she also has a lot of respect for her husband.
她自己也对她丈夫充满了敬意。
So Kashyapa understood there was fault in the activity of Diti, but he saw also the good in her.
Kashyapa, 他也看到了 Diti 所犯的错，但是他也见到 Diti 的好的品质。
So he explained to his wife that, well, she would have two sons who would be of very bad quality. The grandson, one of the grandsons anyway, would be a great devotee.
所以呢，看到这样，他就对的老婆来解释，说明说他们会有两个儿子，而且这两个儿子品质非常的恶劣，但是他们的其中一个孙子会是一个主的伟大的奉献者。
And then this way, Kashyapa is comforting his wife Diti.
所以 Kashyapa 就是这样来安抚他的妻子 Diti.
And he went on to tell about some of the wonderful qualities which this grandson, Prahlada, would have.
Kashyapa 又接着来说到的他们的孙子的 Prahlada 的很多的这种杰出的品质。
How from his very birth he would be a great devotee of the Lord.
就是 Prahlada 在出生的时候就是主的伟大的奉献者。
And he would be kind to all living in.
而且对所有的生物都是非常的友善。
You think of the welfare of the world.
他思考着整个世界的这个福祉。
And he would not have any bad feelings to anyone.
而且不会对任何人存有不好的感觉。
He would remain peaceful and controlled in every situation.
这个孙子呢，会一直心意平和，而且是非常自律的。不管什么样的情境呢，都是很平和的。
Because he's a devotee, he's seen the Lord in everyone, and he understands everything which happens is the arrangement of the Lord.
所以这样的奉献者啊，他可以处处都见到主的存在啊，然后看到主的各种安排。
So in this way, Kashyapa was glorified, the grandson, how Prahlada is going to be a very saintly personality.
So, Kashyapa 就这样来赞扬着 the Prahlada 是怎么样一个神圣的人。
So Srila Prabhupada comments for us about the importance of the wife and the value of having a good wife.
Prabhupada 就说到一个一个好的妻子的重要一个好的妻子的重要性。
Prabhupada describes for a conditioned soul, meaning a conditioned soul means an ordinary person in the material world, The wife is considered to be the source of liberation.
对于一个受制约的灵魂，就是指一般的生物哈，他的老婆被认为是解脱的源头。
Right, gender labor concerned with dharma, artha, and kama, religion, economic development, and sense gratification, the three goals of material life.
一般人在物质世界就想到物质生活的三个目标，一个是宗教性啊，经济发展啊，在感官享乐，一般就是这样的三个目标。
But after all that, then you have to think about liberation.
在前面三个情况都超过，就已经过了，就必须要来考虑解脱了。
And the wife is a source of liberation because she helps her husband.
那么这样一个老婆就是应该是帮助丈夫，让他成为是解脱的源头。
The wife is considered half of the husband, right? The better half.
因为一个老婆应该是被认为是丈夫的好的另一半。
So wife was supposed to cooperate with her husband to fulfill all material desires.
这一个老婆应该是来帮助丈夫来满足他想物质欲望。
Husband should be comfortable in his life. He should be happy and comfortable. Mind should be peaceful.And then in this way he can practice also spiritual activities for the perfection of life.
就是这样子，丈夫呢，他可以生活的安适啊，心意可以平静，这样他才可以有办法心意平静的去进行他的灵性活动。
So very important is to train people for this.
对，来训练人们有这样的知觉和态度是非常重要的。
The husband has to cooperate with the wife. Wife has to cooperate with the husband.
丈夫必须跟这个老婆来合作，老婆也必须跟丈夫合作。
The training is actually there. The men, they should be trained to practice brahmachari life in the beginning.
这个训练是什么呢？就是一个男子呢，在他生活的生命的开始，就要来训练这种成为真守身这样的情况。
If a man is a womanizer, it would be difficult for him to be peaceful in family life.
如果一个男子是在这个追逐女人啊，这样子的话，就很难有平静的生活。
The word is lampata, lampata, in the Shikshastika.
Use
the word lampata.
在八训规里面有这个字 lampata, 就是追逐女人，追求。
So man should not be lampata, should not be a womanizer. He should be trained in brahmacharya life. And the same way the wife has to be also trained.She has to be trained in chastity.
那所以男孩子呢，就必须有这样的训练，培养他们是真守身这样的行为跟态度。那女孩子也是要有训练，就是要忠诚贞洁。
So in this way, then the man and woman can combine as husband, live as husband and wife, and they can achieve the goal of life.
所以有这样的品质的丈夫跟老婆，他们就结合的时候可以来同时达到这个生命的目标。
They can be happy materially, and they can go on and succeed in spiritual.
那这样子的和谐在物质上可以是快乐，变成快乐的，而且继续的在灵修上的进步跟成功。
So the husband has a great debt to repay his wife.
所以一个丈夫是亏欠一个妻子非常的多。
Because the wife helps in this life to be comfortable and can also help him for the next life for his spiritual progress.
所以这个坚贞的老婆帮助丈夫在这一世的生活可以安稳舒适。
So Prabhupada said, the woman cannot repay the debt, the man cannot repay the debt to the woman throughout the whole life.
他又说一个丈夫无法一生也无法完全的偿还对妻子的亏欠。
Because of having the faithful, chaste wife is such a great blessing for the husband.
因为有一个忠诚贞洁的老婆对丈夫是非常的重要，对，有这样的老婆也是一个丈夫的幸运。
So when people live together in Krishna consciousness, then they should achieve the goal of life. They should achieve liberation easily.
所以人在Krishna知觉里面的人呢，应该是算起来一般人更容易达到解脱。
Having a wife at home protects a man from sinful activities.
家里有的老婆的话呢，可以。 帮助这个丈夫去从事罪恶活动。
The wife is like the commander of the fort. The home is like the fort, and the wife is the commander of the fort.
一个家就像一个碉堡一样，这个老婆就像这个碉堡里面的指挥官。
So the man is careful to take shelter of the home, protect him from materialistic, sinful activities.
所以一个丈夫就要好好的脱离这样安稳的家，然后呢，避免去从事其他的这个罪恶活动。
If the home is not peaceful, then the man will go to the bar, he'll go to prostitute, he'll go to other.
如果一个家里不平安，很吵杂动乱的话，这丈夫就心里也会很受打扰，然后会出去外面去酒吧喝酒，或是去外面另外的女子发生关系等等。
But if they live together in Krishna consciousness, then the home is a happy, peaceful place.
那如果两个人都是 Krishna 知觉的话呢，这样的生活可以让他们两个人生活都是非常平和、平静跟快乐。In
the home, you have a temple, and you worship the Lord there.
在家里有个这个庙堂或神坛的话呢，来崇拜神像。You
can invite guests to come to your home, give them prasada.
然后邀请人们到家里，然后也给他们派发prasadam。And
in this way, they will bless you.
而这样子，客人也会来祝福你们的。So
living together in Krishna consciousness is a way in which we can make spiritual enhancement.
所以呢，在 Krishna 知觉的这样生活在一起，人们也可以这样在生活生命中进步。
We see in the modern times there's a lot of divorce. Why is there divorce?
我们看到现代社会非常多的离婚，为什么呢？
It's because people are on the bodily platform. They're thinking only about their sense gratification. They're not thinking about their spiritual purpose.
因为人们只想到。 是身体的层面，想到这个感官的快乐，没有想到在灵性方面的这个益处或什么的。
So when a person feels there's no more sense gratification, then they look for a new way.
就人们觉得家里没有找到感官享乐，就去换个新的老婆。So
the focus is not on spiritual progress.
那种他们的注意力就不是放在灵性上的进步事情。But
if the husband and wife are together, come in the same mood that they both want to make spiritual advancement, then they will live together peacefully.
那如果丈夫跟妻子以同样的心态， 要来得到灵性的进步的话，他们这样可以很和平的住在一起。
All right, so then we're going to hear about Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is called Bhuta Bhavana. He's the king of the ghosts.
我们现在来说起这个 Shiva， 他有一个名称叫 Bhuta Bhavana， 就是鬼魂之王。
So you can see Lord Shiva there in the picture. He is riding on the back of the bull Nandi, his carrier.
我们看到在图片上呢 ，Shiva 骑在一头公牛，就叫Nandi 这头牛上。
And you can see Lord Shiva is carrying his trident, which he uses.
他手上拿着一支山叉戟，就是他在用的山叉戟。
So it appears like Lord Shiva is like a madman. He's not attached to any material things.
好像看起来 Shiva 好像一个疯子一样，他不依附，好像不依附什么这样子。
So Lord Shiva shows an example to devotees how to be detached from the material world.
那 Shiva 在展示的奉献者们，就是说要怎么样来去绝物质世界。
To make spiritual progress, to make advancement, it's important not to be attached to material things.
要灵性进步是非常重要，而就不能去依附物质上的事物。
Lord Shiva dresses very simply.And often he will cover his body in ashes.
Shiva 的衣着非常的简单，而且经常用那个这个坟墓的骨灰啊，那个土涂满身上。
You can see his hair. It's not like he is concerned. He's not much concerned about his physical appearance at all.
然后也看他头发散乱啊。就看出来他对身体的这些装扮或舒适是不在意的。
So he's completely detached from the material world.
所以他是完全的弃绝物质世界。
And he is very compassionate to people because he gives association to people like ghosts.
而且他对人们非常的怜悯。因为他甚至跟这些鬼魂们来交往。
So who gets the body of ghosts?
谁会得到这个鬼魂这样的？
Generally, people who commit suicide.
一般来讲是自杀的人。
When somebody commits suicide, they destroy their own physical body. Next life, they may take birth as ghosts and have to be in a ghost.Ghost means a subtle body, not a gross physical body.
自杀的人就是把自己还应该有的寿命的这个物质身体毁掉了，所以呢，就会得到一个精微的个身体，这种一般称为鬼。
There are two kinds of suicide. One is physical suicide, the other is spiritual suicide.
自杀有两种，一种是我们物质肉体的自杀，另外一种是对灵性方面的自杀。
Physical suicide is people kill the body.
在身体方面当然就是我们一般说的那种自杀。
And spiritual suicide is where a person will try to destroy their own identity, their own individuality.
那灵性的自杀是那一些人在抹杀他的灵性身份。
Just like Maya bodies, those people who take up the Maya body or impersonal philosophy, that is a type of spiritual suicide.
就像那个假象中人士呢，他们的那种概念，哲学概念就是要抹灭个体的灵性的身份。
They are desiring to enter into the oneness of the Brahman and give up their individuality.
那他们的愿望是想要融入这个梵光里，跟梵光融合，抹杀每一个生物个体的这个身份。
So living entities who have these ghostly forms It's a punishment. They're not given a gross physical, they're not given a body. They're just in the subtle form, but they still have desire.
所以呢，身为这个鬼魂呢，他们是被惩罚，只有这个比较精微的身体，但是呢，还是存有着这个物质欲望等等。
Cannot give up desire so easily.
生物也没办法那么容易放弃他的愿望。
So Lord Shiva is so compassionate on these, so that he gives his, he allows these ghosts to be his associates.
这 Shiva 是这么怜悯啊，就允许这些鬼魂跟他成为他们的交友同伴。
We all want to get away from ghosts, you know, we're afraid, oh no, I don't want to go there, oh no, ghosts. We think very.
我们一般人都怕鬼，所以都会赶快听到鬼就会赶快跑啊，离开啊，避免碰到。
So they are certainly unfortunate souls, and we don't, you know, we wouldn't like to be possessed by them.
当然呢，他们算是非常不幸的灵魂呢，成为鬼魂。那我们也不想被他们拥有或被他们抓去。
But Lord Shiva is kind to them, and he arranges that they can get physical body.
那 Shiva 对他们非常的仁慈哈，对他们友善啊，安排他们可以得到一个有形的肉体之身。
And the Vedic scripture describes.That Lord Shiva will place them into the wombs of women who have sex at irreligious times.
那经典伟达经典有描述，希瓦会安排这些鬼魂呢进入到在进行非法性行为的女子的子宫里，让他们可以来出生。
So sometimes you know people say, oh, you know, I know people they had.You know, they had children without marriage, they had children, you know, they didn't follow any, they didn't care about any kind of religious observance or anything. And the children are very nice, the children look okay, you know, they're nice.
有些时候有人会说呢，现在有很多的女子，她们不管对象是谁就发生关系了。而且甚至有的人呢，就也不管对象怎么样，然后就是就会跟他们一起生出一些孩子啊，就小孩子生出来，然后看起来还好。
But it's not a question of physical looks.
但这个情况不是说他身体看起来长得怎么样。
But the actual qualities and character of the persons who are taking birth will be very poor.
而是他们也许长得算起来不错啊，怎么样？可是重点是他们的品格品性是非常的不好。
According to the consciousness of people at the time of conceiving the child, they will attract that kind of soul.
所以就是根据人们在交配的时候，就是圆房的时候，他们的。知觉状态是怎么样，就会把这知觉状态带入那个胚胎，引起那个品质的灵魂来进入这个胚胎。
So we see devotee children, how devotee children are so much better.
所以我们看到这个奉献者们生出的孩子，一般来说都是比较好的。
If somebody is born into the family of devotees.Then it's often an indication that that soul in the last life was already an advanced yogi.
如果说有人从奉献者的家庭里面生出来的人呢，有一个代表一个征兆，就是他们在前一世已经是一个很进步的一个瑜伽修行者。
But the child who takes birth.In an unmarried mother's womb, then that's not very auspicious.
那如果孩子出生在一个未婚女子、未婚妈妈的这个胎中生出的话，这样就 是很不吉祥的。
However, there is still hope for these souls.
但不论怎么样，这些灵魂既然为人呢，都还是有机会。
We will hear the mercy of Lord Chaitanya is for everyone.
所以我们就听到，就主 Chaitanya 的仁慈是对所有各种生物、各种众生。
So Lord Shiva is teaching the devotees how to show detachment from material enjoyment.
所以我们就看到 Shiva 在告诉我们，教导我们怎么样来弃绝物质的各种享乐。
And he is one of the Mahajans, right? He's teaching us the process of devotional service by his example.
Shiva 是这个经典说的 Mahajan 就是一个伟大的灵魂哈，他教导我们怎么样来进行这个像不卖服务这个原则。
Giving up all material enjoyment.
就是放弃所有的物质的享受。
And trying to elevate these souls, giving them, instead of just having a ghost body, at least he puts them into the womb, let them get a physical body.
那就本来那些灵魂可能还是要继续留在鬼魂的身体，但是让他们有机会进入到人类的身体。
So again, here the fault, the faults of Diti, her faults were mentioned here, four different faults.
那么在经典这边描述了说 Diti 的错在哪里，这里有四项。
First of all, herPolluted mind. Her mind was all contaminated with the material desire, the desire she wanted to have union with her husband.
首先就是说她心意被污染了，就是被那个感官的欲望所污染，在这个时候想要跟丈夫生出孩子。
And then defilement of the time. It was not a proper time.
这第二点就是说。她挑的时间不是正确恰当的时间。
She hadn't followed. She was not following the instructions of her husband.
她没有遵循她丈夫的训示。
And she wasn't taking care. She wasn't thinking about the demigods.
She wasn't taking
care. Yeah, she was neglecting the presence of the demigods.
而且她忽略的这些半神人们的存在。
She may say, "Oh no, nobody's watching."
她可能就这么说啊，没有人看到，没有人在看啊。
But Lord Shiva has three eyes.
Shiva 有三个眼睛。
Right, one eye is the sun, one eye is the moon, and one eye is fire.
她三个眼睛，一只眼睛是太阳，一只是月亮，另外一只眼睛是火。
So Lord Shiva could see everything taking place.
所以希望在什么时候都可以看到在发生的任何一切。
But Sati is so overwhelmed by the lusty desire, she's not paying attention to the demigod.
那因为她那么的被这个欲望所征服，所以不去注意到半神人们的这个存在。
So these are her four faults.
所以这是他四个错误。
And because of that, everything was inauspicious.
由于这样综合的情况呢，变成一切都不吉祥了。
And the result was she's going to give birth to two demonic sons.
结果就是他会生出两个恶魔儿子。
However, because of her lamentation, because of her feeling guilty.
但是呢，又由于他后来感到这个难过于他自己这样的犯的错
，and then her penitence and deliberation, her regret, she wanted to make up for what she'd done. She understood she did wrong.
然后呢，他就想要来弥补他所犯的错误，而想来进行一些苦行。
And because of her faith in the Lord.And her adoration of Lord Shiva and of her husband Kashyapa, these are her four assets, her good qualities.
那么呢，再来，她对主有的坚定的信心， 同时她也仰慕的 Shiva， 还有对丈夫的仰慕，这样子呢变成她的一个资产，她的财富一样。
So Kashyapa, her husband tells her that your sons will be demons, but one of the grandsons will be a great devotee.
所以这样子呢，她这个丈夫 Kashyapa 就继续跟她说，她其中的一个儿子呢，她两个儿子会是恶魔，但是其中儿子的一个儿子就是孙子会是一个伟大的奉献者。
So we were talking about the unfortunate position of the, you know, those souls. Lord Shiva is taking those souls and taking those ghosts and putting them into the womb, giving them a body, but bodies with, they're born in, again into not very auspicious conditions.
我们说到呢，希瓦是那么友善，那么仁慈，让那些鬼魂呢可以投生而有一个肉体出生。但是呢，那些鬼魂会投生的身体是出生在又一个不好的情况里，品格上也不好。
Yeah, they're put into the womb of people having not following any religious principles and not paying attention to any proper procedures in conceiving a child.
所以这些鬼魂呢，被放到那一些不。没有遵守宗教原则的这些家庭，哈，或者说在那种非法交往的各种情况里面出生的这样不好的背景。
People just don't know these things. Nobody ever educated people. You know?
世人们就是不知道这些事，没有人就说获得这样的教育。
And so Srila Prabhupada explains, in this age of Kali, there's no discipline.
所以他爸又说了，在这卡利年代，人们对性生活没有纪律。
So then, so how can you expect to get good children if you don't have any discipline?
所以没有规范纪律的话，怎么可能会有好的孩子出生呢？
You have to know how to attract a good soul into the womb.
所以人们必须要知道怎么样来吸引这些。好的灵魂来受孕出生。
And often, the type of child, when the woman conceives, it's often an unwanted child. She didn't want the child.
而且那些没有纪律、没有规范的性生活，造成这些他们生出了不想要的孩子，他们其实不想要孩子，但却怀了孩子而出生。
No, this is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Lord Krishna, Arjuna was talking about Vana Shankara, unwanted pop progeny.
那这一点啊，在这个《波江梵歌》里面，Arjuna也有说到，就是说，不想要的后代啊，Vana Shankara。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was giving reasons why he didn't want to fight. And one of the reasons was he was concerned that the elders will be killed in the battle.
那就是在佛家梵歌里面说的，Arjuna在最开始在提出他不想作战的一些理由，因为其中一个理由就是说家族中的长辈啊会被杀掉的。
And when the elders are killed in the battle, then it means the young people won't keep up the religious principles anymore. They'll become irreligious.
为什么呢？因为家族中如果长者被杀掉之后，年轻的一辈呢，他们不会去遵守宗教原则。
And when the young men become irreligious, the young women will follow them. They'll also become irreligious.
然后，如果这些年轻的男士们呢是非宗教性的，那这个年轻的女子也会跟着他们，都变成非宗教的行为。
And when the women become irreligious, then you get unwanted children. You get this Vana Shankara.
那么，如果女子呢变成也是非宗教性的，那他们这样的情况会造成不想要的后代会出生。
So Srila Prabhupada says, certainly unwanted children cannot be a source of happiness.
所以，Prabhupada就是说，很肯定的， 不想要的孩子出生的话，这绝对不可能是社会上所谓快乐的来源。
Could you imagine parents have children but they didn't want you have this?
你可以想一想，有孩子出生，可是你不想要那个孩子，那种情况会怎么样？
I see here in Taiwan a lot of people have dogs rather than children.
看到台湾就养狗，没有去养小孩。
easier to bring up a dog than to bring up children.
你要养狗比养小孩更容易。
We get some more pleasure from the dog than from children.
跟狗玩胜过跟小孩玩。
So.Prabhupada says, however, Krishna consciousness movement can help to raise these souls who they may be coming from inauspicious circumstances, but they can be raised to the human standard.
Prabhupada 说了，但是经由 Krishna 知觉呢，那可以让一个灵魂，也许在不好的情况。不吉祥的情况里面可以提升到这个哈、啊、这个人类的这样人类行为的标准。
Ghostly haunted souls can be raised to the human standard through the chanting of the holy name. This is the contribution of Lord Chaitanya.
就是有些人被鬼魂骚扰的啦，或是心意很骚扰不平静的这些呢。就可以透过像这个 Krishna 知觉的念诵程序呢，可以得到平静的这个 Krishna 知觉生活。
All right, so we explained this incident between Diti and Kashyapa, how it led to conception, and she conceived two children who are going to terrorize the universe.
所以我们就说到了这个 Diti 跟 Kashyapa 这个情况啊，各种。吉祥不吉祥的结果，然后这个怎么样？这个出生的骚扰宇宙的这个孩子，然后被主所来平服了。
And we want to understand how Lord Shiva is an ideal example for devotional life.
同时，我们也想要来了解 Shiva 是怎么样的一个理想的模范，一个榜样，对我们奉献生活。
Oh, of course, we don't want to imitate Lord Shiva.
当然不想来模仿 Shiva.
Lord Shiva could drink the poison from the ocean of nectar, right?
Shiva 可以去喝那个我们说那个上次他们那个海洋在搅拌的时候那个毒液啊，他可以去喝那个毒药。
We don't want to start imitating Lord Shiva, cover the body with the ashes.
我不想去模仿 Shiva, 把那个死人的骨灰粉涂在身上。
But his mood of being compassionate to other living entities, especially the fallen living entities who are in the mood of ignorance, he tries to be compassionate to them and to elevate them.
然而 Shiva 他的心境呢，对于生物的怜悯，特别是那么堕落的灵魂的怜悯，对他们帮助解救。
Lord Shiva performed many other activities. He drank the poison when the demigods and demons were churning the ocean to produce the nectar. At that time, they produced poison, and Lord Shiva drank that poison.
Shiva 他喝的那个毒液呢，就是当时这个半神人跟恶魔两边在搅拌这个宇宙这个海洋里面呢，想要甘露，可是后来弄出了毒液，那Shiva把这个毒液来喝掉。
And Lord Shiva's throat became blue because of that.
他因为喝了那个毒液啊，所以喝了变成这个他的脖子这个看起来是蓝色的。
So he's called Nilakant.
所以他的一个名字叫 Nilakant.
And Lord Shiva also took the Ganges on his head. When Mother Ganga wanted to come down, when Maharaj Bhagirath was doing austerities to bring Mother Ganges down to earth, it was Lord Shiva who took the Ganges on his head.
还有这个 Bhagirath 他做了苦行，要让这个天上的这个恒河的水降临呢。那这个水 降临的时候是Shiva用他的头来顶住这个恒河水。
Because the Ganges was flowing in the higher planets, but Maharaj Bhagirathi brought the Ganga down here to deliver the sons of Maharaj Sakha who'd been burned to ashes.
那这个恒河的这个水是从更高的这星球降临而来。那么这个时候有一个国王，他的儿子要被所以被杀哈，所以这个巴吉王呢就把这恒河水带到这个地球上。
But the earth, the Mother Ganges was concerned that when I come, when I hit the earth, my impact on the earth will be so great it will knock the earth out of its orbit.
那恒河母亲呢？她想说，她如果恒河水要降落下来的时候，那个冲击力会太大，会把地球冲出地球要走的轨道。
So it was arranged that if Lord Shiva took the Ganges on his head.Then that would stop the impact of the Ganga on the planet.
对，就这样子安排。然后须把的用他的头来顶住恒河水的降临的时候，给他顶住，就不会去冲击到地球。
So the Ganga comes down onto the head of Lord Shiva and then flows down through the Himalayas.
所以呢，这个恒河水就从我们说天堂那边降临到。然后在希瓦的头上，然后在希瓦再把它引到这个喜马拉雅山那边来发源。
So we also mentioned some of the wonderful qualities of Prahlad Maharaj and how he behaved.
我们有提到 Prahlad Maharaj 的非常杰出的品质，还有他的行为。
So when we hear about personalities like Prahlad Maharaj, we should think how we can also follow the example of Prahlad Maharaj.
所以当我们听到 Prahlad Maharaj 的时候呢，我们也应该来想着我们应该怎么样来遵循他的模范。
Just like we spoke about Lord Shiva, how he's an example for us in devotional life.
就好像我们说到，就像希瓦他是我们奉献生活里面的一个榜样。
So also the qualities and behavior of Prahlad are also important for us.
所以呢 ，Prahlad 的这个他的品质还有他行为，对我们来讲是很重要的榜样。
He, even though his father tried to kill him in so many ways, he didn't have any grudge against his father, and he wanted that his father shouldn't go to hell.
即便呢，普拉的父亲用很多种不同的方式要把他杀掉，但是普拉心里没有存的任何记恨哈，一点都没有那些记恨，甚至想要解救他父亲。
And Prahlad didn't have, you know, Prahlad's father had Prahlad, put through so many situations. They threw him off the mountain top. They threw him into the middle of the ocean.And they put him in the well with poison snakes, so many things they did to him. Prahlad didn't bear any grudge against the people who did this to him.
而且呢，Prahlad 的父亲安排了人们把 Prahlad 从悬崖要推下去，然后进到油锅，然后还有又进到那个充满了这个毒液的，还有这个蛇这些山谷。但是 Prahlad 对于那些做这些事的人也没有任何的心怀恶念或憎恨。
So we want to try to show these, to develop these kind of qualities ourselves also.
所以我们呢，也想要来培养这样的品质啊。
People will be impressed if they see this kind of quality.
那我们想要培养这样品质，而且展示出这样的品质，让人们看到这样的品质。
We spoke about how husband and wife should cooperate for spiritual advancement. Many of the Mahajans, they're also householders. It's not that only the renunciates are advanced. The married people are also very advanced.
有很多的伟大灵魂也都是居士，不见得都是那些所谓单身遵守修行的人。
Then Lord Shiva, the incident between each What do we learn from this incident between Diti and Kashyapa about Krishna conscious household of life?
那么，Diti 跟 Kashyapa 他们这夫妇呢，怎教导我们在 Krishna 知觉方面居士的生活是怎么样的教导我们
？Well, teaches us we must be careful.
要很小心的这个教导的。
Krishna consciousness, it's, there's danger, there is some danger there.
在 Krishna 知觉中也有一些危险存在着。
Srila Prabhupada said one time, he said, married life means like going to a feast and fasting.
Prabhupada 说这个婚姻生活就好像你去吃大餐，然后又要很完整的去戒食，去断食。
But there's the opportunity always there for sense gratification. But you have to control.
因为在居士婚姻生活里面，有很多的机会来进行感官享乐，所以必须要知道怎么来节制。
And finally, positive and negative aspects about Diti's action and their result.
然后在对弟弟这个圣人的妻子，他在正面的跟负面的方面的品质是怎么样，然后他的一些行为来讨论他那些情况的结果。
The faults which she had created, the inauspiciousness and the good qualities brought some benefit.
那么就是说他错犯错的地方就带来不吉祥的情况，但是他好的品质的部分就给他后面的这个礼物跟解脱机会。
Okay. Any questions?
各位有没有任何问题？
Anyone?
Yes.
Lord Shiva is so merciful that the ghost have opportunity to be born with a physical body, but then this body, so this person being born is a punishment, or is their karma to have their bad situation when they were born?
Yes, but Lord Shiva is giving them a chance.Change the karma. Karma is not eternal.
是的，是也算是他们一个 karma。但是 Shiva 很仁慈，因为给他们一个机会。这个 karma 不是永远都会那样子，让他们可以改变。
Srila Prabhupada spoke about the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
他讲到主 Chaitanya 的仁慈。
So if they have a chance to associate with devotees and to hear the holy name.Then that karma can all be changed.
对，不管他们出身怎么样，他们还是有机会来跟奉献者联谊，然后karma就会改变。
But in the form of the ghost, very difficult.
如果还在这个鬼魂的躯体，就会很困难。
So they have a better opportunity of ending their karma by coming to the by taking a physical form.
所以他们如果有一个一般的肉体的身体的话，就有比较好的机会可以尽快的来结束改变他们的karma。
So this is Lord Shiva's kindness to them.
所以这是 Shiva 对他们的仁慈。
If you leave them in the ghost body, then they could suffer for eternity.
如果一个
那个灵魂住在鬼魂，鬼魂的身体会可能永久的在痛苦。
We never get free of that.
灵魂处在鬼魂的身体里面，甚至永远没有机会，所以脱离那个鬼魂躯体。
We hear of, we just heard of the qualities of our Shiva and Pranad Maharaj. They are so great. And if we try to develop those qualities, how can we do it? Because we have our own conditioning, you know. So it's so hard to get out of our conditioning, even after years of chanting and, you know, doing service.
Kashapala, 还有这种说 Pala,
Shiva,
Pala, 他们这样的品质哈，就是说说我们尽量要去学习他们，培养他们。但是呢，我们练习这么久，我们还受很多条件的限制，我们被制约这个习惯。那怎么样来去培养他们的那些品质
？Well, that conditioning is our karma.
我们被制约的这些条件状态是我们的业报。
So that karma can be changed by chanting the holy name.
这个被制约的karma 呢，是经由念诵圣名可以来改变。
By taking, just by doing devotional service, and that conditioning can be all overcome.
如果仅仅借着进行奉爱服务的话。这些制约的状态呢，可以来渐渐的被克服。
Yeah, we are all conditioned souls. We have our conditioning. We have our problems. But these things can all be changed through devotional service.
我们都是被制约、被限制的这些生物啊。我们每个人都有自己被制约的状态。但是呢，我们透过奉爱服务呢，我们的这一些制约状态可以去改变。
I have to put full more effort, more energy into hearing and chanting.
所以我们就必须更多的精力放在聆听跟念诵。
And can change.
那聆听念诵奉爱程序可以改变我们的业报跟所有的制约状态。
Hearing is the Maha Mantra or the Mahamantra, or both hearing.
聆听是指啊念诵这个圣名呢，还是说聆听像国家瓦坛，还是说两者
？Yeah, it's all absolute. There's no difference.
这两者都是绝对的啊，在同时也算没有分别。
You can chant the holy name, or you can read Srimad Bhagavatam.You can do both.
可以念诵圣名，可以读国家瓦坛，可以两者都做。
You just simply engage in some kind of service.
就原则就是说，总是进行某一种奉爱服务。
The more we're connected to Krishna through some activity, then that will purify us.
我们由我们的活动里面更加跟 Krishna 联系的话。那我们受制约条件就更加的脱离制约。
那个刚才 Maharaj 有讲到说，那个如果说自杀的鬼魂，那个自杀的人，他就是那个虚法的仁慈会给他投胎在不好的，就是人种出生。那如果说这个自杀的这个鬼魂，他家里的人有在做奉爱服务的话，能不能改变这个鬼魂的投生的状态？谢谢妈妈。
The person who have committed suicide will be by Lord Shiva's mercy take birth in another physical body, may not be so good back surrounding, but if a person suicide but their family members are performing devotional service. That soul, he took birth would be better or any change if their family are performing devotional service.
Is this before he committed suicide or after he committed suicide?
如果说他家人在做破坏服务事，他自杀之后呢，还是他自杀以前就有？就他们的，
如果说之前跟之后有什么不同吗？
为什么 be the difference? Suicide and the other case after the suicide.
Well, if he's in a home where the family are doing devotional service, then he must have heard the holy name. He must have done a lot of chanting. He must have heard a lot of spiritual sounds.
如果这个人他在自杀以前，他家人已经在做婚外服务的情况，就表示他已经有机会听到这些圣灵啊，这些服务的事情啊。
Somehow he's committed suicide. So it's certainly regrettable. It's not good.
就不论怎么样，他发生了自杀这件事，当然会是一件让人后悔的事。
But there's some hope that he will continue in devotional service.
这个人是有一些希望，就是说他继续的后世会有继续进行关爱服务。
Sometimes it happens even that sometimes even a person who's a devotee will sometimes commit suicide.
是有真的这样发生，有奉献者也自杀。
So, you know, obviously they don't go back to God.
当然很明显，他们当然没有回到这个神的王国那里。
But there's some hope. They should be able to avoid being a ghost. They may have to be. You don't know what will happen. Maybe they'll become an associate of Lord Shiva.
如果他曾经奉献着，但是不知道什么情况而自杀，或许他不会变成一个鬼魂，但是可能是变成 Shiva 的一个同游之中的，有可能不确定，因为这个很多因素很难说。
The devotees pray for someone like that. They pray for them, and they even make offerings and so on. Try to petition for the mercy of the Lord. Then it can help. Also the soul.
然后呢，其他的奉献者们为这个自杀的奉献者来祈祷，然后祈求主给这个灵魂来有一个给他仁慈啊，然后让他也可以继续参与这个奉爱途径这一类的事情，为他做一点什么然后也祈求主来帮助这个灵魂。
The human form of body can create karma and change karma.
Yes. It's only in the human form of life you're creating karma.
只有在人类的身体才有这样的功能，在制造业报。
The karma places us in a situation. It doesn't force us to act, but it puts us in a situation.
Karma 会把我们放到一个特定的处境，但是它 karma 不会强迫我们去怎么样行为。
How you act, that's every individual's independent.
一个人怎么样去活动行为是他个体的自由选择。
other species, they don't get karma. They're suffering karma. That body they have is their karma.
动物他们就只是完全受制于这个业报啊，固定的在卡玛的途径里面。
So the ghost body is also karma.
所以得到这个鬼魂身体也是卡玛。So means we also better don't go in the dark usually. Ghosts around.
Dark?
就是我们晚上尽量不要出去，因为外面太多鬼魂了，是吧？
没有那么多。
But if you chant the holy name, you can chant the holy name and deliver them, right?
但是我们可以念诵圣名来拯救他们。
Give mercy.
给他们也人。
They need mercy.
他们也需，他们需要这个人慈。In older custom, that say children and women, they said just don't go after the sunset. I think related to this reason, isn't it?以前我们都听说小孩子还有妇女晚上天黑尽量不要出去，应该基本上是根据这个原因啊，就是晚上的一些阴魂比较多，their mind is weaker, easier to be disturbed. Yeah, in Taiwan also they say that, 就是女子跟孩子的心比较容易被骚扰。
想到一个问题，就是说，那如果我们在路上就是唱诵圣名，会就是说，当然是老师刚刚提到说可以利益那些就是鬼魂，那会不会因为这样而就是说，因为他们想要
跟着你回去，
对，然后对我们有不好的影响，如果我们能量不够的话。
You are saying that even in the night we were outside, we chant the holy name because they need the mercy. But if they also are attracted, they want to come with us, go together with us to our house, what to do, if that will happen or not. Because sometimes our spiritual shakti is not that strong, we might become disturbed by them.
Well, if they're attracted by the chanting of the holy name, that's very good for them.
他们如果受到圣名的吸引，对他们来讲是很好的。
Usually the ghosts are not attracted by the chanting of the holy name.
一般而言，那些鬼魂不会受圣名的吸引。
But if they are, then they're good ghosts.
他们不吸引圣名，吸引他们是好的。
好
魂，我们不会去拒绝他们，让他们来。让他们聆听更多的念诵。
Guru Maharaj, on Tuesday, you mentioned that Lord Brahma and Shiva, they are also affected by false ego. Are they? You were talking about the false ego.
就是说星期二的讲课有提到说 Brahma 跟 Shiva 也受到假我的影响，他们是这样子会受到假我的影响吗？
Well, because they're associating with the material nature, they're not really, but because they have to associate it, Lord Shiva supervises the mode of ignorance and Lord Brahma supervises the mode of passion, so they have to associate with it in that condition.So it has some influence.
因为这个 Shiva 掌管的愚昧属性 ，Brahma 掌管的积极属性。那因为他们的这个职责或功能跟物质能量在接触，所以会受到一些影响而这个假我存在着。
So sometimes may affect them, but they quickly recover.
所以有时候这个假我会稍微影响他们，但是他们很快会自己纠正过来。
Yeah, we're telling about how Lord Shiva got angry at Brihadmuni. He can be easily angered. Lord Shiva is easily pleased, but easily angered.
就好，好像我们说 Shiva 对这个 Brihadmuni 的愤怒，就是 Shiva 很容易生气，但是也很容易被取悦。
So an example means that if you don't get angry, that means you're a very highly elevated person, like Lord Vishnu, who wasn't affected.
所以说，如果都不生气的人，表示这个人是一个很修行很高的。
Well, we learn that there's anger also in the spiritual world, because when the four Kumaras went to Vaikuntha, when they didn't get in.The door, you know, they became angry at Jai and Vijay. So it's pointed out there that there's also anger in the spiritual world.
我们说到在灵性世界也是有愤怒存在，就像这个四个库玛尔他们要进到百昆达的门口的时候，被这个两个守门Jai跟Vijay挡住的时候，他们生气了。
So the anger.Was for their devotional service. If their devotional service is disturbed, then they get angry.
所以他们那样的愤怒，这个生气是为了他们的奉爱服务。那这样子的话，就可以增加他们的奉爱服务。
So there is anger in pure devotion.
所以在纯粹的奉爱里面是有愤怒的。嗯。I think that they...
okay, Srila Prabhupada,
keep going.